What's up, all my Ewoks, Tribbles, Droids, and Wookiees? It's Anna, also known as that Star Wars girl, and today I am going to be talking about all of the drama surrounding Lucasfilm and Star Wars theory. I've been asked about this a lot. I didn't know if I was going to make a video on it, but due to the overwhelming demand of it, I'm here talking about this. So basically, to summarize what's going on, and I'm going to show all of the details over here on this magical side of the screen. So basically what happened was there was this little Twitter thread, and here's the thing. First off, if you're going to talk shit about someone, maybe don't do it in public, because I guarantee you with the way the internet works, they're going to see it. Maybe just don't be an asshole and don't talk shit about people, but that's neither here nor there, apparently. So basically, people were talking shit about Star Wars theory and, you know, making fun of him because he cried at the reaction of Luke Skywalker in the season finale of season 2 of The Mandalorian. And then other people started chiming in. People from, you know, Lucasfilm started chiming in, like Pablo Hidalgo himself, that not ray of sunshine. And so naturally, Star Wars Theory has a huge fan base. They saw it and they let him know about it. And like I think anyone does when, you know, they're getting attacked online, usually people come to their own defense, which is exactly what he did. And it just became this whole little, you know, domino effect of shit happening after another. Other people chiming in to attack Star Wars Theory, to attack the toxic man babies, that are still upset over The Last Jedi. And it's like, it doesn't matter if you like his content or not. It doesn't matter if you work for Lucasfilm. It doesn't matter if you're, you know, just somebody that's watching YouTube videos. He wasn't talking shit about The Last Jedi. He wasn't talking shit about anyone. All he did was react to an episode of a TV show, and he had an emotional response because he's a human being. Doesn't mean you have to agree with that emotional response. Doesn't mean you have to like the emotional response, but it happened. That was his reaction. I myself cried when I saw Luke, when I saw R2-D2 with Baby Yoda. I cried. I was live streaming it as well, and I was bawling my eyes out, and I was happy and overjoyed at that moment because, you know, after what happened to Luke in The Last Jedi, it just knowing that, you know, Mark Hamill must be so happy that he didn't leave his, you know, Luke Skywalker off on that note, that he got some type of, you know, this is Luke Skywalker. So I was crying tears of joy, and it felt like a brick was being lifted off my shoulders, because it had been years and years of, you're a toxic misogynistic man baby. And I was like, well, I'm a woman, so what's your excuse now? It's like, oh, you're a Nazi if you didn't like The Last Jedi. It's like, I'm clearly not a Nazi. You obviously don't know what that means. If, I mean, go do some history. You know, go learn some history. I've been to a concentration camp. Comparing people to Nazis just shows you don't know what the fuck you're talking about. But it's just one of those domino effects. So let's go through it. So I have Star Wars Theory's Twitter here. And I thought it was funny that the thing before all of this happened, his tweet was, "Have a great day, everyone." And, I mean, very simple, short, to the point. That's kind of how he is. Then it just derails. So let's go through it. So Pablo Hidalgo is chiming in on this thread, which is making fun of me for being emotional over Luke Skywalker. "I don't mind trolls, but I can't see what he said, and I'd hate to believe he would join in as a Lucasfilm official. Can someone who can see screenshot his replies?" And then it says, well, here it is, basically Pablo validating that the post undermining my emotions, expected more from someone so high up at Lucasfilm. That's really shitty to see. And so here's the little Twitter thread. I'm pretty sure Pablo was sarcastically saying this. And that's another thing. Pablo said this and then had to retract it, saying he was being sarcastic. The Falls Room guy is trying to say that you artificially made that reaction, lol trolls. And he, what basically what Pablo said is, emotions aren't for sharing. And it's obviously a jab at Star Wars Theory because that's what they were talking about. So here's another one. Pablo chimes in to make fun, deletes the tweet, then puts one of them as his header. And the reason why Pablo Hidalgo put that as his header is because Pablo Hidalgo's account is private because he was saying a lot of shit. And, you know, people were saying, what the fuck are you doing, Pablo Hidalgo? You're, you know, one of the higher-ups at Lucasfilm and you're, you know, trashing your fan base. You know, you're calling women misogynistic man babies, and it's like, huh, misgendering, isn't that one of like your big no-nos? But that's beside the point. Apparently Twitter doesn't care when people like him do that kind of stuff. But let's keep reading. How is this acceptable for someone so high up at Lucasfilm? You're telling people it's not okay to have emotions about the work your company produces, and you make fun of them for crying. Not okay. Which I agree with him, that's not okay. It's like, wouldn't you want an emotional reaction, especially a positive one? Especially, like, look at what the world is going on. What's going on in the world right now? It's 2020. It's COVID. Everyone's been in quarantine. Somebody with millions of subscribers on YouTube had a positive emotional response to, you know, your product. Wouldn't you be happy about that? It's weird how logic just doesn't seem to apply to these people. So this is the tweet from Pablo Hidalgo's account. Emotions are not for sharing. This is, you know, the other people that are talking about it. You feel compelled to have an emotional reaction to Star Wars, by all means have one. I almost cried at the crate in the theater, and I've never cried at a movie in my life, but I don't artificially recreate that shit for millions of followers. So they're talking shit. They're saying that he faked it, which, I mean, it was a live stream where he was having a live reaction to a show. I understand when people say, oh, you faked a reaction when you're, you know, doing a video, and, you know, that thing can be highly edited and stuff, but he was literally on a live stream reacting. So it blows my mind how out of touch these people are. And here it is, the screenshot where he put that as his header. So that way, even though if you're not following him and, you know, he didn't accept your follow because he's got a protected account, you can see it. It's very childish. This is, I feel like, kids in elementary school would do. It's like, oh, you're not allowed in our clubhouse, so we'll put the sign up on the door of our clubhouse, so that way you just know even more, you know, we're not cool with you. It's extremely unprofessional. Then another, you know, YouTuber chimed in, and Star Wars Theory kind of got into it with him. But because of how, you know, the reach that Star Wars Theory has, I mean, he's got 2.78 million subscribers. This got picked up by, you know, the mainstream media. So Variety did a whole article about, you know, how Lucasfilm's execs tweet reopened the wounds of The Last Jedi. And it's like, he wasn't even crying about The Last Jedi, he was crying about Luke Skywalker in The Mandalorian. And so this also has screenshots of, you know, Star Wars Theory's tweets. And then, so Pablo Hidalgo, something happened to his old Twitter account where it got wiped, even though I think he still has it, is what I've seen. But so this was Pablo's half-assed apology, and it says, I wish to clarify that my post that emotions are not to be shared were sarcastic, self-mockery, and was certainly not intended to be hurtful in any way or to anyone, and I'm deeply sorry that it was. As a Lock Live fan, I appreciate the fans expressing how they feel. It's what being a fan is about. So this is a forced response from Lucasfilm, because so what I have heard from the one and only Drunk 3PO, who has been speaking to Star Wars Theory, is that Disney reached out, or Lucasfilm reached out to Star Wars Theory to apologize to him for what happened. He, you know, said, no, I don't accept your apology. And then they made Pablo Hidalgo apologize, which, if you don't, like, this is one of the most half-assed responses ever, especially with everything that has surrounded it. This isn't a sincere apology. And I think that's the biggest slap in the face, is when somebody apologizes to you and you know that they don't mean it in any way. Pablo Hidalgo didn't learn from this at all. I mean, the fact that he has continuously bashed fans for, what, 3 years now and hasn't gotten fired or hasn't had, you know, a demotion in any way, shape, or form is alarming to me. I don't know what the heck they're doing with running this company, but it blows my mind. And so this is just one of the instances. So other people are now, you know, jumping in. So this is from, you know, Disney Star Wars is done by Itchy Baka. So like fourth Lucasfilm turd called Star Wars Theory bottom of the barrel. So this is this guy, Mitch. I am blocked, which is why I have this up with all the screenshots. So thank you for all the screenshots. Bottom of the barrel detected, go away. It's like bottom of the barrel, bitch. He's got almost 3 million subscribers. How many, you know, do you have, Mitch? How many, that's not him working for a company. That's him doing his own thing on the internet with his own time. This is a blue check mark on Twitter talking shit about somebody that built, you know, their audience and their fan base. It's like, bottom of the barrel, let's see what you do without your blue check mark or without, you know, a company behind you. Let's see what you do. And so then here, this person, Ian Miles, I have no idea how to say his last name. He started chiming in because Star Wars was trending. He says, grown men crying on YouTube over children's movies will never not be absolutely fucking pathetic. I loved the Quarterine's response. Vera Dark had a great response. Drunk3PO had a great response, but this, it's icing on top of the cake. How back when you worked for me and said you need an assistant only for me to find out it was some e-girl you were sending money to and then crying. Ironic, huh? People just jump on the trends to hate. And then there was even one from a while ago, like Steel Wars podcast. If you're still harboring the resentment about being referred to as a man baby 3 years later, guess what? And that's him jumping on it because it's like, they call people grifters. They call, you know, Jeremy from Geeks and Gamers grifter. They call Nerdrotic grifter. They call me. They call other people, you know, that just talk about pop culture because this is something we're interested in. They call us grifters, but it's like you're jumping on because this has been trending on Twitter. The Star Wars Theory drama has been trending. So he jumps on it, and I had a lot of time on my hands because I went up for Christmas to go visit my family, which is a 7-hour drive. Boyfriend was driving. I didn't, you know, internet wasn't loading anything. So I was like, I'll organize my photos because I'm running out of memory. And I found these screenshots that I took years ago. And, you know, this was him talking shit about Jeremy from Geeks and Gamers, who he is also referring to here in this tweet because Jeremy has been defending Star Wars Theory. You know, Drunk3PO has been defending Star Wars Theory. A lot of YouTubers have been talking about this, and he's obviously bitter about it. And so, you know, look at his tweet from what, this is 2018. Hilarious that some treat finding women that agrees with them like some bizarre superpower. So this was actually about because me and Jesse Miles Stone had our first stream over on Geeks and Gamers. Me and Jesse met for the first time and we did a stream on the Geeks and Gamers channel. So he was kind of pissed off about that. So my response to this, are you still harboring some resentment for a guy you've been calling a man baby for the past 3 years because he's more successful than you, stands up for others? Which obviously, look, this was from last night. I took this screenshot, all of the videos that he did defending Star Wars Theory. And you know, he, you know, more successful than you, stands up for others and has more female friends than you, maybe you should build a bridge and get over it. Which it's true. Look, he just, everything that this dude has been doing, and these two screenshots are from 2 years ago. This guy has been having, you know, a hate boner for Jeremy for over 2 years. If the people aren't, you know, he's the one still pulling that man baby thing. So it's funny. It's funny how this all works. You know, people just chiming in to go hate on Star Wars Theory, who did nothing wrong. He didn't. He had a reaction and people started talking shit about his reaction, and then he was defending himself like I think anyone would do when they're getting attacked. And especially for something over, you know, something so emotional like Star Wars, that's, you know, obviously he loves Star Wars. He's got a whole channel on it. He's based his career on it. He did a Star Wars, you know, fan film about Darth Vader, which, you know, he was kind enough to invite me onto the set, or, you know, he had me and Jeremy from Geeks and Gamers on the set. I've met Star Wars Theory. He's a Star Wars fan. He's, you know, he's got the biggest Star Wars channel out there on YouTube, and people are just dogpiling on him because it's trending. And it's funny because after all of this with Pablo Hidalgo, magically on LinkedIn there appeared social media manager for Star Wars, and then, you know, if you follow the link, it goes, you know, even over to Disney Careers, social media manager Star Wars. I might actually apply for this because it would be it would be interesting to see. Oh, you know, I'm a woman of color. I'm dyslexic, which I've been told is a disability. I'm also practically blind. Thank you, glasses and stuff like that. But it's just, it's funny how now that they're, you know, execs have been bashing the fan base for years, and all of a sudden now it's getting all this attention. Ironic how that works, right? But then something magical happened today, right before I was about to do this video. Mark Hamill, this is his way of chiming in. Sometimes the greatest gift are the most unexpected and something you never realized you wanted until it was given. Thank you, John and Dave. And it's the, you know, the image of Luke Skywalker reappearing and us seeing Luke in The Mandalorian. So it's like, you see the way that people react, or some people react, and then the way that others, you know, Ryan Johnson even did a tweet where he was talking, oh, tears streaming down my face, in a passive-aggressive way, you know, to chime into all of this. So this is getting a lot of attention, and tonight, Drunk3PO is actually going to be doing a stream with Star Wars Theory and Jeremy from Geeks and Gamers. So the link for that stream is in the description of the video. Everything that I've shown is in the description of this video if you wanted to go see these tweets for yourself. If it wasn't clear enough up on the screen, if you want to see any of the things I posted, all of the links are in the description of this video. So go over and subscribe to Drunk3PO. His channel is blowing up right now, which is awesome for him. But go make sure that you subscribe, ring the bell for notifications. When you ring it, make sure that it's set to all. That way you get notifications for when he does this live stream later, because trust me, you do not want to miss it. It's going to be, you know, Drunk3PO, it's going to be Jeremy of Geeks and Gamers, and it's going to be Star Wars Theory all live later tonight over on Drunk3PO's channel. So go check it out. So that way you can get, you know, everything that I've talked about, but from the sources himself, from Star Wars Theory himself. So everyone, you know, I hope you liked this video. I hope it was as informative as, you know, you wished it would be. I made sure that I got everything all together before I chimed in and talked about this, because there was a lot of stuff to talk about. So thank you so much, everyone, for watching. Thank you so much, everyone, for being here. If you liked this video, go ahead and smash the like button. If you didn't, that's okay, too. Thank you so much for watching this far through. And until next time, everyone, I hope you have a great rest of your day, morning, evening, afternoon, wherever you are in the world. And may the Force be with you, because we are really, really, really going to need it. Bye, everyone. What's up, everyone? It's Anna, also known as That Star Wars Girl, and I have an Etsy store, so if you've ever wanted to own a print of my artwork, this is the place to go. As you can see, I have a lot of recognizable characters, from horror films to heroes to Star Wars characters. Some of the notable characters I have on here are Darth Vader, which I did a couple live streams painting, so you can own a print of this painting. I also have Luke Skywalker, the binary sunset version, one of my favorite scenes in the original New Hope movie. I have Darth Maul, which Ray Parks himself actually complimented me on Instagram. And then last but certainly not least, Ahsoka Tano. So if you want to own any of these prints, go right on over to my Etsy store. Again, that's The Art of Anna, That Star Wars Girl, or TSWG for short. Thank you, everyone, and have a great rest of your day. What's up, everyone? I have a P.O. box, so if you want to send me some mail, go ahead and send it to Anna, That Star Wars Girl, or TSWG for short, at P.O. box number 28171, Santa Ana, California, 92799-8171. Have a great day, everyone. Thank you so much.